Hello and welcome to this online concert here from Warsaw in Poland, from an amazing new church, the Church of the Presentation of Our Lord in Warsaw, with an amazing new organ, only completed in 2021 by Zich Organ Builders, a very well-known name in Poland, slightly French in style, but a big, amazing and very, very beautiful and musical sound. I'm here to do a concert and Tom is here, my brother, filming and recording, and we wanted to bring you the amazing sound of this instrument. As you'll hear, there's an incredible acoustic, so I'm just going to give you a few pieces from here to show the various sounds. We began with Tchaikovsky's Polonaise from the opera Eugene Onegin, telling the tale of Tatiana, who meets Eugene Onegin, instantly falls in love with him, writes him a letter. He rejects her. Cut to 5 years later. She appears at the ball to this piece of music, this wonderful Polonaise, now a beautiful aristocratic woman. Eugene Onegin, who rejected her when she was younger, realizes what a mistake he made and then returns his love for her. However, she rejects him and leaves him alone in despair. Another typically happy ending to an opera, but a wonderful, wonderful, joyful piece of music and suitable for Poland, with, of course, being a Polonaise. I'm going to move straight on to something which, of course, is very suitable to being here in Warsaw, a piece of Chopin. Chopin, of course, grew up in Warsaw, probably the most famous Polish export as a musician, really. The airport is even named after him. An amazing, amazing pianist and, of course, composer, and wrote many, many pieces for piano. And one of the most famous, which I'm going to play for you now, is the Raindrop Prelude, Opus 28, number 15. The legend around this piece is that while on holiday in Valdemossa in Mallorca, it was a very rainy night, and the sound of the rain on the roof with this insistent note non-stop in the middle is what sort of inspired the piece. And all the way through this Raindrop Prelude, you hear this G-sharp, A-flat repeated all the way through, very insistent. And also because Chopin was staying at a monastery there, people often think that there's a very sort of chorale, monk-like chant in the centre of this piece. It grows very big and dies away again. This is a very sort of orchestral, warm version I've done, so I hope you enjoy it. This amazing piece of music, The Raindrop Prelude by Chopin.
Thank you.
very, very well-known music, but great to have to play it as an organ solo, especially in this acoustic where it's almost like the pedal of the piano holding the bass sounds on in this amazing church. I'm going to move on to a piece by Guillemin now, the introduction and allegro from Organ Sonata Number 1. Probably Guillemin's best-known work, very, very dramatic, and also available in a version for organ and orchestra as a concerto, a piece I've played as well, but I think the organ version works really well, and I do reintroduce some of the effects from the orchestra with some jumps to the chamade trumpet sticking out the front of the organ. Very famous also, after the introduction, for the pedal solo, with this amazing driving sort of rhythmic theme. Guillemin is almost in many ways, sort of quite Germanic in some ways, very much like Bach, but also very, very romantic and of its time in these sort of softer, quieter sections. Some amazing effects and some great virtuosic pedal writing. Hope you enjoy this. This is the introduction and allegro from Symphony No. 1 or Sonata No. 1 by Alexander Guillemin. a great way of showing this amazing organ and this, the great sort of French influence. When you look at the specification on paper, it's very much of the French style. But it's also very good at doing very musical and very sort of delicate sounds as well, which we'll hear in the next piece, Nimrod by Elgar. I thought it was great to include a British piece, and probably one of the most famous, if not the most famous British piece in the world. Originally from the Enigma Variations, variation number 9, Elgar wrote the Enigma Variations to depict his friends within. Originally, one of the enigmas was to try and guess who each person was, because he coded the names or changed them. So Nimrod is the biblical hunter king. Nimrod in German, or the hunter in German, is Jaeger, and Elgar's publisher at Novellos in London was Jaeger. And so it was his friend. And so he wrote this after a discussion about Beethoven's slow movements of piano sonatas. And those of you who know the slow movements of the Pathetique Sonata by Beethoven will recognise how this begins in almost an identical way. Very famous, very beautiful, but the great thing that this organ will do, or hopefully I'll be able to do on it, is to build up from almost nothing to full organ and back down without you really hearing the addition of sounds. It's so well voiced and so expressive. It's in two towers, so you get this amazing surround sound inside the church. And I think this is absolutely the perfect piece to demonstrate that effect on this instrument. So I hope you enjoy this. This is Nimrod from the Enigma Variations by Edward Elgar. an incredible contrast of sounds going from absolutely nothing up to full and back down. You should hear it in here. It's absolutely amazing. I'm really looking forward to performing a live concert here. So I hope you've enjoyed having the opportunity to hear this wonderful, wonderful instrument from Zig. And it's a rare opportunity because in the UK we don't hear a lot of great Polish organs, but there's some amazing, amazing instruments here. And this is, I think, an amazing example of great, great organ building and great voicing as well. So I've really enjoyed looking around it and playing it and exploring all the effects and sounds. Thank you to Tom for filming and recording, and thank you to everyone at the church for making us so welcome today. To finish with, I'm going to play a really, really famous piece of organ music, Suite Gothique by Leon Boelmann, written in 1895. It's famous because it's such a sort of Gothic piece, really. There's the introduction chorale, which uses the full organ sound pitted against the resi swell sound as a contrast. Then there's a little menuet Gothique, a little sort of 3-4 dance-style movement. Then there's the Prière Notre Dame, which, depending on how you translate it, there was a mistake sometimes in the published editions. It's either a prayer in Notre Dame or a prayer to Our Lady, depending how it's written out. And then finally, the famous Toccata, which many people always think is very sort of silent movie in its style, very much like the Vidor style of Toccata, with a figuration in the manuals and a melody in the pedals. An incredible use of the organ, the way it builds up, and perfect for this sort of French style of instrument. I hope you enjoy hearing all four movements of this. I think it's one of those pieces which everybody learns when they're first learning the organ, and it's one of the earliest pieces of organ music I played. And I don't play that often nowadays, but I thought in this amazing church with this acoustic and this instrument, I thought it'd be a great opportunity to bring it to you. So I hope you enjoy this. Thank you for watching again. And this is Suite Gothique by Leon Boelmann.